Hello students, welcome to our Don Bosco Tinsukia's YouTube channel. Myself Ashok Das. Today we'll discuss quadratic equations of class 10. We'll discuss what is a quadratic equation, then what are the different rules by which we can find out solutions. So let us start without any delay. Quadratic equations. An equation of the form ax square plus bx plus c equal to 0. An equation of the form ax square plus bx plus c equal to 0 is called a quadratic equation. Called a quadratic equation where a b and c are real numbers, where a b and c are real numbers and a is not equal to 0. So quadratic equation means an equation of the form ax square plus bx plus c equal to 0 is called a quadratic equation, where this a, b and c, these three things are real numbers and a cannot be equal to 0. Now we'll discuss about the discriminant of a quadratic equation. Discriminant. Let me to erase it. Discriminant of a quadratic equation. This b square minus 4ac, b square minus 4ac, it is called the discriminant of a quadratic equation, and this b square minus 4ac decides about the roots, nature of the roots of the quadratic equation. So b square minus 4ac, if the equation is ax square plus bx plus c equal to 0, then for that equation b square minus 4ac, this value will decide what will be the nature of the roots. For example, nature of the roots of a quadratic equation is decided by the value of b square minus 4ac. There are some rules where we'll get, if b square minus 4ac's value is greater than 0, then we'll get two distinct real roots. Then if b square minus 4ac is equal to 0, we'll get two equal real roots. And if b square minus 4ac is less than 0, then no real solution. I'll write it on the board. First of all, let me to erase it. Nature of the roots. As I have already told, if b square minus 4ac is greater than 0, b square minus 4ac is greater than 0, then two distinct real roots. Then two distinct real roots. Then number two, if b square minus 4ac is equal to 0, if if b square minus 4ac is equal to 0, then we'll get two equal real roots. Then we'll get two equal real roots. Equal real roots. And number three, if b square minus 4ac is less than 0, if b square minus 4ac is less than 0, then no real root, then no real root. Let us see once again this nature of the roots. So if b square minus 4ac it is greater than 0, then two distinct real roots. We'll get two distinct real roots. If b square minus 4ac is equal to 0, then we'll get two equal real roots. Mind this, equal real roots. And at last, if b square minus 4ac is less than 0, then no real root. Now we'll learn different methods by which we can solve a quadratic equation. We are going to learn different methods by which we can solve a quadratic equation. First of all, let me to erase it. Different methods for solving a quadratic equation. For solving a quadratic equation, number one, method of factorization. Method of factorization. Then number two, method of completing the square. Method of completing the square. And the third method is by using quadratic formula. By using quadratic formula. So these are the three methods by which we can solve a quadratic equation. These are method of factorization, method of completing the square, and at last by using quadratic formula. Now one by one method will apply for solving a quadratic equation. Let us take one example, one question at first. Then by different methods, we'll try to solve that equation. Solve. Question is say 5x square minus 13x plus 8 equal to 0. I have taken one example, 5x square minus 13x plus 8 equal to 0, one question, and this question we are going to solve by all those three methods which I have discussed just now. So before that, let us check what will be the nature of the roots. So how to find that discriminant? Let us try to find here. So here a equal to how much? A equal to 5. A equal to 5. Then b equal to how much? Minus 13. So it is minus 13. And c means that constant. So c equal to 8. We are going to find the discriminant, that is b square minus 4ac. Therefore, b square minus 4ac is equal to. Now in place of this b, we will put this value which is minus 13. So we'll write minus 13 whole square, then this minus, formula's minus, then 4ac. So 4 into a. A how much? A it is 5, and into c. C how much? 8 into 8. Now minus 13 square, minus 13 square, that will give us plus 169. Minus on squaring, it will become plus, and 13 square, that gives us 169. Then minus 4, 5 jar 20, and 28 jar 160. So 169 minus 160, that gives us how much? 9. So 9. So what do you think? Is it greater than 0? Is it equal to 0 or is it less than 0? Obviously, it is greater than 0. 9 is greater than 0. So as I have already discussed, that if our discriminant, that is b square minus 4ac's value, is greater than 0, then we get two distinct real roots. Therefore, the given quadratic equation has two distinct real roots. Therefore, the given quadratic equation has how many roots? Has two distinct real roots. So after doing this step, that is after finding the value of b square minus 4ac, we are sure that we can solve it. Since b square minus 4ac's value we have got greater than 0, so according to that first condition, first rule, that if b square minus 4ac is greater than 0, then the given equation has two distinct real roots. Mind the words, two distinct real roots. So we have confirmed that this equation has two distinct real roots. Now by different methods, we will solve this quadratic equation. Let me to erase it. Our first method is method of factorization. We'll solve it by the method of factorization. Method of factorization. So question is 5x square minus 13x plus 8 equal to 0. So to solve this quadratic equation by the method of factorization, our first work will be to find the product of this constant with the coefficient of x square. Here what is the coefficient of x square? It is 5. And what is the constant? Constant is that number which is 8. So our first work is to find the product of 5 and 8. So if we find the product of 5 and 8, that will give us 40. Product of 5 and 8, that will give us 40. Now 40's factor we'll find, and then with those factors we'll make two groups, so that product of one groups, when we'll add to the product of other groups, the sum should be equal to 13. So let us find the factors of 40. This will give us 220 jar 40, then 2 10 jar 20, 2 5 jar. So all the factors of 40 are 2 into 2 into 2 into 5. We have got here 4 factors. Now with these 4 factors, we'll make two groups. In one group, by trial and error method, we'll keep these factors in one group. It may be 2 factors in one group and 2 factors in another group, or it may be 3 factors in one group and 1 factor maybe other group, or any other arrangement. Our aim should be, when we'll add product of one group of factor to the product of other group of factor, the sum or the difference should be equal to how much? Coefficient of this middle term. That means 13 we have to get. So for getting 13, we'll adjust this factor in such a way so that we can get 13. So after looking at this factor, we can understand that these 3 2's, if we keep in one group, that will give us 2 into 2 into 2, 8, 2 2 4 4 2 8, and in other group I can keep 5. So in one group 8 and other group 5, if I keep like that way, then on adding 8 and 5, on adding 8 and 5, the sum will be equal to how much? 13. So in place of this 13, we can write now 5 plus 8 or 8 plus 5. Anyone, we can write at first, either we can write 8 plus 5 or we can write 5 plus 8. It will not hamper our solution. Same answer we will get. So implies 5x square minus, so in place of this coefficient of middle term, we will write 8 plus 5 or 5 plus 8. I am going to write 5 plus 8, bracket close, then that x will come down plus this 8. 8 will remain same in its own place, is equal to 0. This implies 5x square, it will remain same in its own place, minus, I will remove the bracket. Since outside the bracket there is minus sign, so when I will remove this bracket, this plus 5 will become minus 5. Minus 5 into x, that will give us minus 5x. So it is minus 5x, and once again minus into plus, that will give minus, minus 8 into x, that gives 8x. So minus 5x minus 8x, and then that plus 8 is equal to 0. Now from the first two terms, what can we take common? If we look at this first two terms, we can see 5x can be taken as common. So on taking 5x as common inside bracket, here in the first term we will be left with x minus. In the second term, from 5x we have already taken 5x common, so only one is left, so that one. And from the remaining two terms, that means from minus 8x and plus 8, I can take minus 8 common. So minus 8 on taking common, we will be left with inside bracket x, and that plus will become now minus because we have taken minus sign common. So this plus will become now minus, and from 8 we have already taken 8 common. So here 1 is left, bracket close, is equal to 0. This implies now from this x minus 1 and another x minus 1, from these two x minus 1, 1 x minus 1 will take common. And after taking x minus 1 common, here we are left with 5x minus, here we are left with 8, that equal to 0. Now from x minus 1 equal to 0, we will get one root, and from 5x minus 8 equal to 0, we will get another root. That means we'll either or we'll have to do. We'll have to do now either or. Therefore, either x minus 1 equal to 0, or that second one, which is 5x minus 8, 5x minus 8 equal to 0, or 5x minus 8 equal to 0. From x minus 1 equal to 0, minus 1 if we send to other side, that is right side, it will become plus 1. So x equal to 1 we will get, and from the other equation, 5x minus 8 equal to 0, minus 8 at first we will send to right hand side, that will give us 5x equal to 8. And in the next line, we can get x is equal to 8 by 5. X equal to 8 by 5. So therefore, the required two roots are 1 and 8 by 5. Now conclusion we'll have to write. Therefore, the required roots are 1 and other one is 8 by 5, 1 and 8 by 5, which is our answer. So this sum we have solved by using method of factorization. Now the same sum we are going to solve by another method, second method, that is by the method of completing the square. Let me erase this. Second one is, question will remain same, which is 5x square minus 8x minus 13x plus 8 equal to 0. Now by the method of completing the square, method of completing the square. So we'll write the question at first, which is 5x square minus 13x plus 8 equal to 0. To solve a quadratic equation by the method of completing square, our first work will be to send the constant term to right hand side. That means this plus 8 will send to right hand side. Let us do it, which will give us 5x square minus 13x is equal to plus 8. After changing the side, it will become minus 8. Minus 8. Next work is, whatever is the coefficient of this x square, whatever is the coefficient of x square, by that coefficient, we'll have to divide all the terms. So here we can see the coefficient of x square is how much? 5. So we'll divide all the terms by 5. Let us do, which will give us 5x square by 5 minus 13x by 5 equal to minus 8 by 5. Here after cancellation, we'll get x square minus 13 by 5x. It will remain same in its own place, and right hand side minus 8 by 5. This also will remain same in its own place. Next work is, we'll try to make our left hand side in the form of a plus b whole square or a minus b whole square, whatever is possible. A plus b whole square or a minus b whole square. You know that a square plus twice ab plus b square is equal to a plus b whole square, and a square minus twice ab plus b square is equal to a minus b whole square. A minus b whole square. So whatever is possible, either we may get this or we may get this one also, any one we can get. For this, some adjustment at first we will have to do here, then only we will get either this first one or this second one. Let's see how to do this adjustment. So x square, this x square we can write it as x whole square. After that, another thing you notice here, that b square term, whether it is a plus b whole square or it is a minus b whole square, a square and b square, these two terms are always positive, whether it is a plus b whole square or it is a minus b whole square. In both cases, a square and b square, they are always positive, but twice a b term, they differ. In case of a plus b whole square, it is plus 2ab, but in case of a minus b whole square, it is minus 2ab. Now here, this 13 by 5, before it there is minus sign. That means this 13 by 5, altogether minus 13 by 5 x, it will be our twice a b term. So we'll have to adjust in such a way so that this one minus 13 by 5 x, we can make it as a twice a b term. So for that, what we'll do, we'll write 2 ourselves. Let us write 2 ourselves at first. So 2 we have written ourselves into, inside this bracket whatever it is written, same thing we'll write, which is x, 2 into x into. Now in place of b, we'll have to write such a term so that the product of those three terms together will give us minus 13 by 5x. So what shall we have to write so that product we can get as 13 by 5x? We have to write here one term in such a way that the product of these three things together will give us 13 by 5. And it is possible if we write here 13 by 10. If we write here 13 by 10, then only it is possible, because this, see, this 2 and 10, they are cancelable. After doing cancellation, 2, 5 are 10, we will be left with here 5. So 13 by 5 into x, 13 by 5x. So as an adjustment, this here we have written 13 by 10, so that the overall product will become minus 13 by 5x. Now here whatever thing we have written, the same thing square we will have to add. Whatever we have written, the same thing square. So 13 by 10 means 13 by 10 square. Whatever thing for adjustment we have written here, so that the product should be equal to minus 13 by 5x, the same thing square always will write, same thing. Then that equal to equal to will give, previous line there was equal to, now also this equal to will remain. So whatever extra thing, mind it, this is the extra thing which we have written. This extra thing we have to write once again in right hand side also. So that extra thing is 13 by 10 whole square. And then we will see previous line. In previous line, right hand side, what is written? It is minus 8 by 5. So the same thing once again we will write, which is minus 8 by 5. Now if we look at this left hand side, we can see it is in the form of a square minus twice ab plus b square. So a square minus twice ab plus b square. So this will give us a minus b whole square. So in place of these three things, let me to write here. In place of these three things, x square minus 2 into x into 13 by 10 plus 13 by 10 whole square, we can write a minus b whole square, where a is our x. A is our x minus b. B how much? It is 13 by 10. So x minus 13 by 10 whole square is equal to, right hand side, let us simplify a little bit, whatever simplification is possible. So 13 by 10 whole square, 13 square, that gives us 169, and 10 square, that will give us 100. So altogether 13 by 10, 13 by 10 whole square will give us 169 by 100, and minus 8 by 5, that number we have to carry. So same thing we'll write, minus 8 by 5. Left hand side, it will remain same. So keep it same, x minus 13 by 10 whole square. Right hand side will take LCM. We have to take LCM of 105, and you know LCM of 105 is 100 itself. Now LCM divided by this denominator 100, that will give us 1. So 1 is the quotient into numerator 169. So 169 into 1, that gives 169. Minus, once again, LCM 100 divided by denominator of the second fraction, which is 5. So 100 divided by 5, that gives us 20. So 20 is the quotient into numerator 8. So 28 there, that gives us 160. So left hand side will carry x minus 13 by 10 whole square is equal to 169 minus 160, that gives us 9 by 100. Now this right hand side, from x minus 13 by 10 whole square, we have to find x minus 13 by 10. So this square will have to drop. Now if we drop this square, right hand side will have to take square root. So this implies x minus 13 by 10 equal to, now if we don't write this square, right hand side we have to take plus minus. Plus minus and then square root. Square root of 9 by 100. Square root of 9 by 100. Left hand side, just carry it, x minus 13 by 10 equal to plus minus, square root of 9 is 3 and square root of 100 is 10. Next line, this minus 13 by 10 will send it to right hand side. After changing the side, minus 13 by 10 will become plus 13 by 10. So this implies x is equal to, we'll get 13 by 10, then plus minus 3 by 10. Then 10 will take LCM. We'll take 10 LCM, x is equal to LCM 10, and numerator will remain same because LCM is 10 divided by this denominator 10, that gives us 1, 1 is the quotient into numerator 13. So 13, 1 is 13, then this plus minus sign, it will remain same in its own place, and once again LCM 10 divided by denominator 10, that gives 1, 1 is the quotient into numerator 3, so 3, 1 is 3. Now either or will come, once we will take this plus sign and then in the next line we will take minus sign. So either x is equal to, therefore either x is equal to 13 plus 3 by 10 or we will get x is equal to, minus sign now we will take, or x is equal to 13 minus 3 by 10. 13 minus 3, that gives us 10. So 10 by 10, that gives 1. And here 13 plus 3, that gives 16 by 10. After doing cancellation by 2, that will give us 8 by 5. So therefore, the required two roots are, therefore, the required two roots are, one is 8 by 5 and other one is 1, which is answer. Now, if you compare this answer with previous method, you will see that these two answers are same. In previous method, that is by the method of factorization also, we got our roots as 8 by 5 and 1. And now in this method also, that is by the method of completing the square, we have got the same answer, 8 by 5 and 1. So in exam time, you will not be written that you use this method or that method. So whatever method you feel comfortable, you can use it. So first method is method of factorization and second one is method of completing the square. Now there is another method, third method. Have you remembered that name? Yes, that method name is by applying quadratic formula. So now same question we are going to solve by the method of quadratic formula. And there also we'll get the same answer. So third method, quadratic formula. And our question is 5x square minus 13x plus 8 equal to 0. So here a how much? A equal to 5, coefficient of x square which is a, that is 5, then b equal to minus 13, this is, and c equal to 8, c equal to 8. So quadratic formula which is given by x is equal to minus b plus minus, minus b plus minus root over b square minus 4ac divided by twice a. This is the formula by which we can solve a quadratic equation. X is equal to minus b plus minus root over b square minus 4ac divided by twice a. Now in place of a, b, c, looking at up, we will just substitute the values. Just looking at up, we will substitute the values. So b, minus sign, it will remain same in its own place, and b is how much? It is minus 13. So keep minus 13 inside bracket, then plus minus, root will remain same in its own place, then b square, once again b's value is minus 13. So minus 13, it will remain same, b square it is there, so minus 13 square, minus 4ac, so 4 into a, a how much? It is 5. Into c, c how much? It is 8, c 8, divided by twice a, so 2 into a, a how much? Once again it is 5. Now just you'll have to simplify it, that will give us answer. So minus into minus 13, minus into minus 13, that will give plus 13. So 13, then plus minus, it will remain same, square root, minus 13 square, minus 13 square, that will give us plus 169, then minus, here what is the product, 45z 20 and 28z, that will give us 160, 160, whole thing divided by 2 into 5, that gives us 10. So 13 plus minus root, 169 minus 160, that gives us 9. Whole thing divided by 10. So this is equal to 13 plus minus square root of 9. Square root of 9 will give us 3 divided by 10. Now like earlier also, once again either or we will get. One time we will take plus, other time we will take minus. Therefore, either x equal to 13 plus 3 by 10 or x equal to 13 minus 3 by 10. Now 13 plus 3, that gives 16 by 10, and after cancellation 2 8 jar and 2 5 jar. 2 8 jar and 2 5 jar, that will give us 8 by 5. 8 by 5. And here 13 minus 3, that is 10. 10 by 10 after cancellation, that will give us 1. So therefore, the required roots are, like earlier, we have to write again. Therefore, the required roots are 8 by 5 and 1. So once again, we have got the same answer, 8 by 5 and 1. So you have seen that in all the three methods, for the same question, we have got the same answers. Root should be same, whatever method we apply. So unless otherwise stated in question paper that you use this method or that method, you are free to use any method. Whatever method you feel comfortable, you can use it. If you are given, just solve it. Okay, thank you for watching this, our YouTube. Hope we'll meet soon once again. Thank you.